This week's Tech Talk is about chassis, and we're in the Mark VDS garage with Sam Lowe's bike because Calix is the most successful chassis in Moto 2. So I thought we'd run through what adjustments they have on their chassis. So, like all classes, tires are the limiting factor, grip. So when for example, last year Dunlop had a new rear tire. This year they have a new front tire, and the grip level has changed. And when a tire grip level will quickly get pushed to the limit by the riders. Then they come in and work with the teams to try to get the maximum and more out of those tires, suiting the rider's riding style. So this is really tricky. First of all, so we have the grip. Goes up through the suspension. We've spoke about suspension in another tech talk, and then it goes through the triple clamps here. So the triple clamps are adjustable, both flexibility wise, they have harder and softer, but also offset. So the center of there to the center of the forks, that distance is the offset. So the bigger that is, the less trail you have. The smaller that distance is, the more trail you have. And let me give you a little example of the feeling of the offset change. I first felt it on a factory superbike going from 30 offset to 27. The 30 felt light from side to side, and when you got on its side, it didn't turn as much. I put the 27s on, it was a little bit heavier, but as you leaned over, the bars physically turned and the bike turned a little bit more. It felt a little bit more positive. I think that's the extra trail. Then also you have these inserts in the chassis, and this I've got one here to show you, and you can move this steering head position further forward or back, which makes the bike, or makes the chassis longer. And the reason for this is if you have that distance from the center of the crankshaft to the wheel too short, there's too much weight on that front tire, yeah, it will turn in the middle of the corner, but when you brake, it'll push that front tire forward, you know? There's too much weight, squash it, push it forward. If that distance is too big, you can brake like a demon, but when you get on its side, it's too long, it won't turn as well, and there's always that, optimum number they're trying to stick to. And the reason they need to be adjustable there is, for example, if you go steeper on the head angle, that's a shorter distance between crankshaft and front wheel center. Then, steeper means less trail. To get that trail back and get some feeling, you go smaller on the offset, which gives you more trail. Two times that wheels come closer, then they can adjust the steering head position forward to get that number back again. So everything's a compromise and adjustable. So just while we're up the front here, I thought I should show you handlebars. See the offset here of the handlebars. So to suit the riders, they can have a bigger offset like Sam's got on here, or a smaller one. You know, it moves the rider forward or back for whatever reason. Then of course it's adjustable this way and height wise on the fork leg. Right, let's move to the back of the bike and speak about the same things. The tire. The most important factor in all of this. Then it goes through the force of the tire through into the swing arm. Calix make swing arms that are shorter and longer. You go shorter and longer with sprockets and chain length, but as soon as you get too long, you'll hit the end of the adjuster, they make a longer one. As soon as you get too short, you can run the shorter one, depending on rider preference. So length and flexibility. So they make a softer swing arm and a stiffer swing arm the riders can choose from. Then the next thing the force goes through would be into the linkage, okay? And the linkage I have up here, an example. Linkage, the swing arm pulls on this and pushes the shock, okay, the rear shock. And all of these distances are adjustable. So when you have a linkage that's more linear, okay, more flat, that's the words for it, the angle goes like this on the graph, but what it means is the more you push on the seat, the back of the bike goes down, it doesn't get much harder. And that means there's not much force on the rear tire, you know, so you're not giving the rear tire a hard time. But maybe you need a more progressive link, change those distances again, and you get push on the rear of the bike or open the throttle, and the rear suspension gets harder faster, puts more force into the rear tire. Maybe that's what you're looking for. They've got all extremes, trying to find the right number. Then they've got an adjustable link that makes it faster or slower. And I thought, what does that mean? Alex from Calyx explained that instead of 10 mil movement at the swing arm means 2 millimeters movement at the shock, it will be 10 mil, for an example, will mean 5. So you feel the shock damping more, you know? So all of these things are adjustable. Is another one? The swing arm pivot. See, it's offset there. You can run that up that way or that way, you know? And that goes where the swing arm is mounted here. So what it does, I know we've explained it a little bit with sprockets, chain and sprockets tech talk, but basically it's about chain force. Chain force is very important. Riders like a particular chain force, because if you have a low swing arm pivot, big chain, and low chain force, then you open the throttle, the weight will transfer easier. The chain will pull the rear wheel up, and the bike will squat. No force going into the rear tire. The other extreme is when the pivot is high and the sprocket smaller there. When you open the throttle, it extends the swing arm, pushes the tire into the road, pushes the back of the bike up, keeps the steering well, but it puts a lot of force into that rear tire. And somewhere between those two extremes is the right number, where it looks after the tire, gets the grip, and keeps the chassis in the right position. So look, can you imagine how easy it is for these riders and chief crew chiefs to get lost? You know, so many adjustments. I hope this gives you a little insight on what they need to do during a race weekend. See you at Brno for the next Tech Talk.